you're running the top strategic trends project internally. What's your favorite one this year?
Wow, I love all my children. But again, I do have my favorites. And I think it's one of the hottest trends. It's a now trend, which is 1 to 3 years, mm-hmm. right? And that's multi-agent systems.
Oh, yeah.
Right? So we started to build agents, but we've seen organizations kind of build the monolith agent. It's an agent that does many, many things, and it's very complex. And then it becomes
extremely slow and expensive to run.
Correct.
Yeah.
So what we're seeing is many are starting to say, whoa, what if I make a specific agent that now it has a specific test? And I liken it to an F1 pit crew, right? Your business is the F1. It has a complex challenge to win the race.
It's amazing the turnaround time in those pits.
Indeed. Indeed.
And they have some specialized tools to do that.
Exactly.
That everybody knows exactly what they're doing and how it's choreographed.
Correct. So they're able to know. The radio is telling them they're coming in, needs brakes. Mm-hmm. It needs tires. It needs fuels. The driver needs this. Mm-hmm. And all of a sudden, you've got the left front tire. Mm-hmm. I've got the right front tire. We are so specialized that we can do it quickly, synchronous together. Mm-hmm. This complex product, and we get the car out quickly.
Really?
And multi-agent systems, because it's of its modular design, those agents and the specificity that they do reduce hallucinations.
Yes.
All right, which bring the accuracy up. And now when you coordinate them around the complex product or process, they can deliver a great results quickly. Mm-hmm. And also, they can change. They can call other specific process. So multi-agent systems is one of my favorites. But one thing behind it that is domain-specific language models.
Yes, exactly.
Right? Now, we have models. They're very broad. They've indexed the entire web and everything written by mankind.
And they stop being useful for specific types of tasks.
Correct.
Yeah.
But what if we had one just for building codes? Right. And a contractor was able to feed in the plans of a project and it comes back with, these are your code violations. And you can fix it at the drawing level versus finding out when the inspector.
So you have like a code compliance agent that's checking always the things you're creating.
Correct. So as part of designing a new facility, it will constantly be checking the code and say, hold on, you put that door near where there should be a fire exit, or you're short a fire exit, and it's going to catch it in the design, not in the field.
Yeah, interesting. So I remember having a conversation with one of the F1 teams, by the way, just to go back there.
That's pretty
cool. And we were talking about telematics in the car.
Yes.
And doing it for fan purposes, so you could actually track, you know, all of the statistics. And you see that when you see it now them on TV.
Yeah.
But the other thing is that basically if something happens to the driver, the car will drive itself into the pit.
Yes.
And then that led to a conversation of them saying, well, actually, you don't need drivers at all.
Correct.
In the F1 cars. But then they said nobody would come to watch.
Perfect.
Why do you think that nobody would come to watch? What do you think the answer is?
Why would nobody come to watch
a driverless F1?
I think, you know, it's funny. If you think of the original space missions, right? They weren't going to put a window in because they said the pilots wouldn't pilot. And the pilot's like, hold it, we're pilots.
So there is that.
If something goes wrong beyond all the things that you've calculated, we're going to handle that.
See, this is the answer. This is the answer I wanted. So, yeah, that's probably a really good answer. The actual answer is people come to see the accidents.
Yes, that's true.
Right? They want to see the human element of that. And that's, you know, it's
a most popular injury, broken ankles.
Really?
Yes.
Why?
They're in the front.
You don't mean popular. Most common.
Most common.
Okay,
yes.
Let's be clear
most
about
common.
That.
Yes, that's true. Yeah, that's a greater, better phrase. I'll let you have it.
Yeah, I remember being in Singapore when the first F1 race that they did in Singapore was in place. And Singapore is a fascinating and fabulous city for lots of different reasons. And not least of which is their ability to completely flex around an F1 race.
Yeah.
You know, and that, again, is sort of how rigid are we, how agile are we in order to create the experiences that people need and not be disruptive about them.